Now, having battled breast cancer twice in the last 10 years, Anastasia has made headlines after revealing she's undergone a double mastectomy. In just a moment, she joins me for her first TV interview since the news broke, after a quick reminder of her story. When Anastasia was first diagnosed with cancer in 2003, she was a superstar, one of the world's most successful female artists with two multi-platinum albums. She was only 34. After radiotherapy and a partial mastectomy, Anastasia went back to what she does best, having huge hit records and touring the globe. 5 years later, she was in remission. But in February this year, she was diagnosed with breast cancer for the second time. Forced to cancel her European tour, she admitted the treatment was more intense this time round. In July, she tweeted from the recording studio that she was cancer-free, and just 2 days ago, she announced her double mastectomy, joining other stars Angelina Jolie and Sharon Osbourne, who have also had this procedure. Well, Anastasia joins me live from Los Angeles. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. How are you?
Hi, sweetheart. How are you?
Good. How are you? How are you feeling? How are you doing?
I'm really feeling much better. It's been unbelievable. The ride has been way more intense than I thought, but I'm so glad to be talking to you. I'm so glad to be on your show. I'm so grateful to be part of Been Your Bra. This is very exciting.
I know. We're going to talk about that in just a minute, and which is great that you've been part of that for us too. Was that a really tough decision, Anastasia, to have the operation?
Yeah, I have to say that that when I did get diagnosed that I finally had it for the second time, my doctors really advised me to get a mastectomy, and I had already thought prior on my first go around with cancer, if I'd got it again, that I probably would choose a double mastectomy. I was hoping I wouldn't get it again. So it was one of those things that I think I had kind of prepared my head enough for that decision when it was the decision to make. And any journey down that road is not easy for a female, period, but You gotta do what you gotta do, and I'm cancer-free forever, breast cancer-free at least, and that is been all worth the struggle.
No, absolutely, and we know that, you know, Angelina Jolie has had the operation, Sharon Osbourne as well, and Sharon and you, she's actually helped you quite a bit, hasn't she?
You know, Sharon, Elton, they have been more than friends, more than respectful in just being tea time buddies. They've really, really been so embracing every aspect of giving word and attention and love when is needed. And that is, they've really done that for almost everybody I've ever spoken to that is ever involved with them. I am so grateful that they find the time and out of their crazy schedules to even care about how I'm feeling and what's happening with me. It means the world. It really does.
And obviously with what's happened to you, it does raise awareness. And I know that you yourself, you do inspire other women too. And you've saved lives by speaking out, because you've always said that you have to check yourself. You have to know your body. I know how important it is to you.
Yeah, I advocate early detection. I advocate raising awareness. I advocate to more young women. My fund, the Anastasia Fund, through BCRF, Estee Lauder's foundation, really helps the younger woman. And so the money raised is for early detection in cancer, for some, you know, younger women to get mammograms that can't afford it, because in America we do have to still pay until you're 40, then you get it for free. How great is that? But I just really think that any kind of speaking and communication when it comes to a disease that is so sheltered, you know, women don't want to really talk about this because they don't want to add more attention to something that could be negative. And I think the more you talk, the more negativity that ever surrounds the word cancer just goes straight away.
You're absolutely right. And I know that you're recovering very, very well. You're looking absolutely fantastic. And I guess, in a way, music, because you're so passionate about your music, It's really good medicine, too.
Oh, my goodness. Boy, oh, boy. I have to tell you, if I didn't have this album to do, it would be much harder. The cathartic, inspirational songs that have come about in this procedure this year, let alone the last 3 years of life that I've had without an Originals album. My goodness, I am so excited. I was just in the studio today, and it's hard for me. I don't want to talk about it and say that it's the best album in the world, but it is, you know, I mean, seriously.
Well, you should know. You should know, Miss Anastasia. And look, I have to say a massive thank you because you sent this to us last week. This is Anastasia's brassiere. It is a beautiful bra, as you can see. And we're going to bin it in the nicest possible way. Thank you, Anastasia, for giving us your bra. Thank you for talking to us today. It's gone right in there. There it is. And stay well. And come and see us when you're back over in the UK, please.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sweetheart. Lorraine, thank you so, so, so much for everything you've done and everything you always do.
Thank you. What a fantastic, fantastic lady. From one inspirational woman to many more. Last month, we asked you to nominate your Woman of the Year, someone who inspires you or has achieved something fantastic. We had over 1,000 nominations, and it was down to judges Barbara Windsor, Baroness Helena Kennedy, and myself to pick out 3 finalists.